From the Oklahoman Newsroom, this is an OSU update. I'm Jenny Carlson here in studio with Scott Wright, OSU beat writer. And Scott, Oklahoma State, basically a two-point conversion from not only winning Bedlam on Saturday, but getting bowl eligible. They still stand one win short of that six-win mark that you have to be at to get into a bowl game. So as close as that call was with two games left, you got to think they get there. But if they get to six, where is there? Where are they going to go, Scott?
It could be a lot of different places. That's the interesting thing is they're in a strange situation because the first thing that determines where Oklahoma State might fall in the pecking order is how many Big 12 teams get into the playoff or into a New Year's Six Bowl. Obviously, West Virginia is one of the teams that's pursuing one of those options. Oklahoma State's got to play them, so by actually beating them, it might change their own bowl future in multiple ways. But if they can get that sixth win, whether it's West Virginia or TCU, the options seem to be at least three or four possibilities. Really the Liberty Bowl seems to be a good option out there right now that the Cowboys could land in if they fall that far. Then there's also the Cheez-It Bowl, which is in used to be the Cactus Bowl out in Phoenix, and the Armed Forces Bowl, which is the seventh bowl on the Big 12's list. It's hard to say whether or not Big 12 is actually going to get seven teams, so that might even be a long shot. If Oklahoma State does get bowl eligible, it's hard to even envision them falling that far because they do have a good reputation of traveling well and having a good national brand. So I think that they would be attractive to one of those bowls before they get that far. But the Fort Worth Bowl there, the Armed Forces Bowl, is still a possibility.
And other possibilities include Alamo, Texas, and Camping World. But Scott, I mean, not to say that those bowls wouldn't take them if the Cowboys were there, but they've been to those bowls. Camping World last year, and they've been good in those spots, but does that change the dynamic that maybe those bowls might be looking to pick another team before Oklahoma State because OSU has been a regular in some of those spots?
I would think so. You know, the Alamo Bowl is up at the top of that list. Once you get past the New Year's Six bowls, they're going to have the first pick from the Big 12. You don't expect them maybe to drop down to take a team like Oklahoma State when they've got some ranked teams in the field right now that they could select from. So that's going to be a long shot. Even though Oklahoma State has gone there and had a good reputation with the people in San Antonio, that's going to be a long shot for Oklahoma State to land there. The Camping World Bowl, you don't expect them to bring the same team back again. The Texas Bowl could be interesting to watch because that could be a place where Oklahoma State becomes attractive, but you've got Texas A&M as a possible opponent there. It's an SEC game. You could have a team like Texas or Texas Tech sitting around, and the Texas Bowl would really love to have one of those matchups, so particularly Texas. But
yeah.
So that could be something that sort of stands in the way of Oklahoma State getting to that game, which is down in Houston. So it would be an interesting picking process, sort of draft process almost, to watch how teams come off the table and where everybody lands.
And just to remind people, even though these bowls have an order, they don't have to pick who's in that
right
spot. If a team is ahead of another team in the Big 12 standings or even in the rankings, it's not about that. It's really who does the bowl want. And as you mentioned, you know, that Texas Bowl matchup, a Texas A&M versus another Texas team, if they're there, if they're eligible, whether that's the next team on the list or not, they're taking that team.
Yeah, absolutely. Just to speculate, they might even like Baylor, which would be a nearby team that might like to come to Houston and play in that game. So, that's a team that Oklahoma State would obviously be ahead of rankings wise, most likely, or standings wise.
Yeah.
But it might be a more attractive team to a particular bowl. So a lot of factors that come into play, and it seems like Oklahoma State could end up a lot of different places. Sort of leaning toward the Cheez-It Bowl in Phoenix at this point, but things, first of all, they've got to get that sixth win.
Right.
Now if they go win two and get to 7-5, that could change the whole dynamic as well.
Lastly, when you talk about the two that seem most likely, the Cheez-It and the Liberty.
Yep.
Liberty Bowl is a matchup with an SEC team. Cheez-It Bowl would be a matchup with a Pac-12 team. There are some interesting potential opponents there for Oklahoma State. If OSU fans, a little down in the dumps, maybe not a more high-profile bowl, they could still have a really fun matchup in a bowl game.
They absolutely could with those two conferences. You look at an SEC opponent that could be, say, Missouri, Texas A&M if they don't end up in the Texas Bowl, maybe South Carolina, which is intriguing. One of the popular picks on the national bowl projections for the Pac-12 team going to the Cheez-It Bowl is USC, which obviously not the type of year that they want to have right now, but that would be a lot of fun to see to the Cowboys and the Trojans going at it in Phoenix. So some really interesting options. It's a good opponent and a most likely a high-profile opponent that Oklahoma State could end up playing against.
All right, but like you say, they got to get to six, and that next opportunity comes Saturday as West Virginia comes to Stillwater. It's Senior Day. We'll have lots of coverage of the game as we get closer. And now Senior Day, that's a 2:30 start on Saturday. So be sure to stay with the best coverage team anywhere at NewsOK.com and every day in the Oklahoman.